Good morning, Blazers. Today is Thursday, February 27th.
Now please stand for the pledge.
Please stand for the pledge. I pledge allegiance to the flag of the United States of America and to the republic for which it stands, one nation, under God, indivisible, with liberty and justice for all.
Welcome to InfoFlow. I'm Amina.
And I'm Sashua. For today's Black History Month facts, gospel music is a genre of Christian music originating in the 17th century in the South as an expression of African music, religious experience, and music.
If you're interested in being a team manager for either the JV or varsity baseball team this spring, then please attend a mandatory meeting in Mr. Schemmer's room, portable 7, during lunch tomorrow.
International Night will be held on Friday, March 13th, and the SGA would like people to audition to be a part of this show. Please sign up if you have a cultural performance you want to showcase. Applications will be kept outside of room 161 and will be due on Friday, February 28th. Further auditions details will be on the form.
Now let's check out part two of our ongoing Purple Line miniseries.
Construction of the Purple Line, which will connect New Carrollton to Bethesda via Silver Spring, is well underway, with bridges, tunnels, and construction equipment littering the streets of downtown. The transit line will run along Wayne Avenue in the style of a streetcar, meaning that construction will occur directly on the street, which is adjacent to Silver Spring International Middle School. We talked to the school's principal, Karen Bryant, about how the construction will affect commuters and students alike.
So the Purple Line is a really interesting phenomenon for us in that we, I believe, are the only school in the state of Maryland, definitely in Montgomery County, who is as directly impacted by the Purple Line coming.
Over the past 15 years, the town of Chevy Chase has made efforts to oppose the building of the Purple Line. We talked to the Chevy Chase mayor on the town's history with the Purple Line and why construction will affect locals.
There was also a strong group that was very opposed to the trail, feeling that this was a beautiful piece of green space, that they felt terrible that this was being destroyed. And then on top of that, many of those people believe that all the estimates for the use and the ridership of this train were very excessive and were not going to happen. And it did divide the town. It was a contentious issue.
One of our students was asking a question, well, after the Purple Line is actually here, do we imagine that students and staff will actually use that to come to school? Kind of hard to imagine since we're some years still out from it, but something to think about.
Stay tuned for part three, Blazers.
It's that time of the year again. Come out next week for Blair Interracial Dialogue Week. Bring your friend and prepare to participate in diverse activities and discussions on various topics, including the model minority, bias, and privileges. These events will take place during lunch and after school. For more information, check out the flyers posted around the school. They look forward to seeing you there.
The Weeb East Club meets every other Wednesday of every month in room 352 from 3 to 4 p.m. They have an international night coming up, and any dancers available are welcome. Also, they have guest speakers lined up to talk about the SAT, ACT, and PSAT test prep, and about the culture and politics of other countries. Make sure to join them for an interesting night and learn more about other cultures.
Blazers, the movie Selma will be playing today in the auditorium during lunch. If you are interested in the civil rights movement, Martin Luther King Jr., or simply African-American empowerment, then make sure to check it out.
Attention all students, please vote for our fellow Blazers fan favorite C-SPAN student cam videos. They are titled Democracy Must Be Learned, which can be found at the link below, and Seeds of Change, which can be found at this link below. Congratulations, Blazers, and make sure to vote for them.
That's the end of today's show. Check out our website, bnconline.net, to submit announcements, and follow us on Twitter at bncblay or on Instagram at bnc.infoflow. Have a triumphant Thursday, Blazers.